Hey YouTube, today I'm going to show you how to create a game on Unity. This is being split up into a lot of different parts, so if you need help, go to the other parts on some stuff. So I opened up Unity here with my new terrain I just created. And if you don't have these packs, I'll put all of these packs in the description for you. And it'll be put into one folder. So you just take it out of a zip folder and drag it into the desktop and then put it into Unity. So when you create your terrain, as you can see, I have a blank terrain here with nothing in the background. It just looks really fake. So what I'm going to do is click the paintbrush, and I'm going to go to edit textures. You can do whatever texture you want or whatever texture you have. So I'm going to click on my little circle, and I'm going to type in sand. You can click whatever sand you want. And now I'm going to add some trees. So I want to go back up and go over, no, actually add some mountains. And the height of the mountains is going to be about 225. I'm going to zoom in, press F to zoom in. And I'm just going to, oh, that's too small, 600. And I'm just going to make some mountains here. As you can see, the mountains go up. Alright. I'm just gonna draw random mountains across. Turn up the brush size so it'll be bigger. Okay. So then I'm making some mountains here. That's all I'm going to do for now. And now I want to add some trees. So go to edit trees, add tree, and type in tree. Click on the thin tree because the other ones are just black and white trees. And tree height, about there, 165. Tree density is how many trees will be close together. I'll do about 96. And so, you can zoom out for this and just add trees. It doesn't look like a lot, but when you zoom in, it's really a lot. It's almost like a jungle. Actually, no, I need to focus because then it'll start lagging. Yeah, it's already lagging, whatever. So there, I have my trees. And now what I want to do is I want to add a player to this game. Or no, actually go to game object, create other, spotlight. Oh no, delete that. Game object, create other, point light. There we go. And click on move, the move tool. And bring this up about right there. And go down to the range and drag the range out. Focus on the terrain really fast. Alright, then go back to the point light and click on range and just click and drag it to the right. Okay. So there, it's a little brighter. Now we want to add a player to our game. So since we have nothing in here, if you have all the packs, you would go to standard assets, which is right here. Go to prefabs and go to first person controller. Click and drag it into the game view. As you can see, when you drag him somewhere, it shows what everything looks like. So the trees are pretty tall and there's a lot of them. So I'm gonna rotate him really fast. Alright. And if I press play, he just sits there. I can't move him or anything. That's because he has no scripts. If you want to add scripts to him, we go to component, script, and we go down to FPS, walker, add, click add, and you'll see that pop up. And as you can see, this is his run, how fast he'll run. The 10, how high he can jump. The 10, and the gravity is so he doesn't just go floating in the air. As you can see, he falls under. It's because you don't have him set high enough, so I want to focus on him. See, his body's halfway in the ground, so bring him up a little bit. first play, he doesn't fault them that, but you still can't move him. So I'm going to go to project view and go to the search bar, type in mouse, and then mouse lift script right here, and drag that in there. You can leave all the settings normal. And now I can move him around with my mouse, and I can move with the arrow keys. And as you can see, it's just a random blue black background. We're going to change that so it can actually look like a sky. So what I'm going to do is go to my main camera, and you see skybox right there, and go to the skybox custom skybox. Now we're going to type in low engine, and it's right there. That's our skybox. Click and drag that into there. And now when we press play, we have an actual sky. And there's my first person controller right there. That's what he really looks like. But since it's first person, you can't see it anyway. So I can move around, I can jump. And yeah, so that's what we'll be doing, creating a game like that. And now that we have all of that, we can add in something for our first person controller. What I like to do is just add a weapon for him randomly. So if I add a weapon for him really fast, so I'm gonna go to machine gun and take the machine gun prefab and drag it in there. Move this so it's in front of him the right way. Rotate it. Scale it so it's big enough. Okay. I already have a texture set for my gun because of all the game levels and stuff I've been trying to create. So it's already set. But before you drag it as a child up into the first place controller, I want to go to create empty and drag that in there. Drag that under the main camera now and rename it weapons and duplicate that and rename it machine gun. Okay, now drag the machine gun into the fake machine gun now. Now for the weapons. For this, we need a script for this. So go to component, scripts, player weapons, switch player weapons. And player weapons script, drag them into weapons. Now, for this one, we need the machine gun script. So just click and drag that in there, and then go to add. As you can see, it needs a muzzle flash. The muzzle flash is right here. Just click and drag it right there. Okay. So, now it needs sparks. So, like, when you shoot, it actually shows stuff being shot. So, we're just going to type in sparks right there. Click on either one. Either one's fine. Now, I'm going to rotate the spark so it can be in the right spot. And move it, and it's kind of rotated the wrong way. Alright. Move it closer to the gun. Move that up, and kind of, alright, and now you can't scale the sparks. So if I press play, can't see the sparks right now. See, the sparks need to be a different color. Oh, that's why, that's why. I'll make the sparks a child object for the real machine gun, so it'll follow it around. Now if you press play, you still can't see the sparks, but that's why we're going to make the sparks a different color. So we're going to delete those and select the other sparks, the ones that are purple, so you can see it better. And we're going to rotate this. So it's in front of a white square. Now that is a child object with a real machine gun again. Now, we press play. See, shoot sparks. That's a good thing, we want that. Okay, so what I like to do, I like to add sound clips for my gun next. So whenever I shoot, it'll make a sound. How to do that when we're a component? Audio source, and as you can see, here's your audio source. I add a machine gun clip, which is loopable. Machine gun loopable. Add that and press loop and go click off create on awake. So when I shoot, it makes a looping sound.